Hello, this is Rob from Fit Fast to 50, and today we're talking about a number of different things. A little niggling injury and how it happened. We're talking about a new pair of shoes I picked up yesterday. Ooh. So,
we're gonna go this way because that way I see the tracks. See, this way, look up ahead, breaking trail, first one's out. I think it's about 8 o'clock, so it's not early, it's actually quite late, but nothing like being out in the forest, on the trails, after fresh snowfall, it's really beautiful.
So, what did I pick up? What did I pick up? Totally unintentional. 10 centimeters, maybe a bit more, of snow yesterday. Spring snow, nice and soft, wet snow. And I went shopping with my daughter. She wanted to pick up some gear. And we stopped at one of the shoe shops I normally frequent. And these bad boys in my size were standing on the floor in a blowout. 50% off. 119 Canadian and normally about 240 Canadian. These are the Salomon Snow Spikes. Now, this is a shoe I would normally never buy, not at that price anyway, because of a number of reasons. First of all, it's a 10 millimeter drop shoe. Second of all, it's quite a narrow shoe. And third of all, well, it's just not the kind of shoe that I'd normally go for. But at that price, and looking at some reviews over the years, I just couldn't quite resist. Deep lugs, titanium spikes, and with all the snow that's coming, I grabbed them, I had to grab them. So I tried them out this morning. How did it go? Well, two dogs in tow, Canny Cross, two German pointers. That puts a lot of horsepower in front of you. They're tied around the waist with a Canny Cross rig. I'll show that to you at some point. And I went out with these guys and man, they performed really well. Now this shoe is built like a tank. It's hard. There's no give. There's no give at all. Okay, no give. Deep lugs and on the asphalt, on the tarmac, where the roads had been scraped, it was a punishing shoe to run, and it felt like running on a 2x4. But once I got out there in the soft snow and in areas where there was a bit of freezing under the snow, this shoe was just phenomenal. I didn't feel the 10 mil drop, which I normally don't like at all because of the soft snow. The heel, as you can see, there's a you know, it's not a straight shoe, there's a bit of a heel here. And this, I think, is designed to clear out the snow, so I have no clogging up of the lugs in the snow. These little titanium spikes did a great job of gripping when I needed grip. And with a bit of a toe forward, I found I could get into that snow, get traction, and get moving. I really like them. I think these shoes are probably going to last me a long time because it's the kind of shoe I'll probably only use maybe a half a dozen times a year. But at that price, this kind of a shoe, I think, is going to stick around for a while. And I'm happy I bought them. If you come across a pair of Salomon Snow Spikes, you live in the Northern Hemisphere where there's lots of many snow days where you want to get out, it's a good shoe to try. Good shoe to try. As you can see, there's the Salomon lacing system with a normal sort of shoe on the inside. It's got an ortholite insole, and then it's got this booty kind of system, very reminiscent of a Nordic ski boot that, you know, clips over here and helps to keep snow and stuff out of your shoe. Now, this wasn't snug around my heel, and I don't think there's a way to adjust it, but what I did was I had my running pants over that, and I stayed beautifully dry the whole time.
Easy. 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 You grab on the tree there. The dogs have to learn that easy means easy. Whoa. Hope you're enjoying the scenery with me this morning. It really is beautiful. deer trail. Deer spur, I mean. On the way home, feeling good, nice out. Just meet one other person on the trail so far, walking his dog, which is perfect. Wind's picking up, leaving us some snow. Snow from the trees, that is. Always reminds me of Darlene Mathieu's book, Circles in the Forest, or in Afrikaans, Kring in die Bos, where she describes the forest at Knysna, or Knysna, in South Africa. And then she says, I'll say it in English, and after it rains, something like this, of course I'm paraphrasing, after it rained, the forest, after it rains, the forest would continue to give its own rain for a few days, because the water would land on the canopy, and then as the wind blew, then it would continue to rain, or deposit that water onto the earth. It's a bit like this today. It's not snowing from the clouds. It's snowing from the trees. Snowing from the trees. Tree snow. It's our bench. Well, I didn't really want to be out here. Treadmill running is probably my least favorite thing ever. Treadmill is just not my kind of thing, and I need to get a few more miles in. Okay, got off those crazy roads, crazy traffic, crazy icy. Back on the trails, not with the snow spikes, with the hokas, because I wasn't intending to be back here, but now on the snowmobile trail, loose snow. But you know what? It's peaceful. Gotta watch the snowmobiles, of course, but at least you're not dealing with friggin' cars and splashing water and icy sidewalks and all kinds of other nonsense. Okay, so in there is a trail back home. We're gonna take this trail here. We're going to go up and around, stay at the snowmobile trail. It's probably gonna be soft and mushy, but you know what? I think it's going to be worth it, just to get away from all the nonsense. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Easy. Let's see. Whoa. Whoa, guys. Pepper, Ellie. Back. 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 Pepper. Back. Okay. That didn't work out. That didn't work out at all. Knee deep snow there. No way. No way, Jose. Trail just became soft, sunk to our knees. Well, you know what? This is part of living in this kind of climate, and part of living in a northern hemisphere. And we're gonna head back on this trail through the bush, back to Hidden Lake area and Karp, and then make our way home. And I think that'll be it for today. Hoodie is back on, gloves are back on, because here's where the wind is. This is where we have to be careful. Scraped, plowed roads. Don't look too bad, but they can be really slippery. This is Pepper. This is Pepper. Can you see him? I don't know if you can. This is Hot Pepper, Johnny Macaroni.
Oh, you're my boy.
You're my boy.
He's my guy. He's a good boy. Anyway, that was it's quite the adventure out there. I'm here now, gonna get in the rowing machine. Gonna finish off on the rowing machine. I need to stretch out anyway, need to cool down. That was tough out there. Surface is just tough all around. But anyway, back home, and we'll see how it goes. Gonna just do probably 20 minutes on the rowing machine. Call it a day, and try again tomorrow. Welcome to today's version of, well, this week's version of Rob's Rambling with Ellie Pacelli. This is Ellie Pacelli. She's our female German short-haired pointer that I run with. And I don't know where Hot Pepper Joni Macaroni is. He's probably upstairs enjoying a treat. But Ellie and Pepper are my running partners and my canine running partners. And they run, we run Canny Cross style. And it's actually kind of part of a little reason why we got a little bit injured, but not the whole story. So running Canny Cross with these guys with all that dog power, it's not unusual to get little ankle sprains, and I did. I had a small mild inversion injury of this ankle with just a mild sprain, which actually was not the problem. The problem is that I also do swimming, fine for Ellie, and in our swimming practice, our coach got us to do swim drills with these flippers on, and if Ellie gets out of the way, you'll be able to see. Come on, sweetheart. And anyway, what happens is this rubber edge on the flipper, in addition to the swelling from the ankle, causes a bit of stress and pressure on extensor digitorum, and that's a tendon that helps lift your foot up, so dorsiflex your foot. And during the swim drills, doing that repeatedly with a bit of swelling, this rubber pressure created like a pressure point, a chafe point on that tendon, and now I've got a tendonitis of extensor digitorum. Not a train smash or anything, but it is painful and it is annoying, and it's a bit of a downer, you know. The thing is, you know, we're going to get injured when we do run and we do things, and sometimes like this, it's something fairly trivial that gets added to by something else fairly trivial to become an annoying injury. It's not going to stop me, hopefully, but it happens. So little injuries happen, and if they happen, you know, we've got to deal with them. We've got to look after them and heal them up, but we've got to keep going. And don't get discouraged when you do have a small little injury. And if you've got a doggo, yeah, they're great. They're great. Love my doggos.
Yes, I'm fine. I'm just sweating. I'm fine. This is what happens after a workout. I get my face washed.